Hi, welcome to this Data Science Dojo tutorial on part 2 of automating the task of web scraping for analyzing text. In part 1 of this video tutorial, you followed along while we wrote an R script to scrape hourly Bitcoin news, summarize the text, and send the summary in an email alert to ourselves. In part 2, we'll set up our web scraping script to run as a background task on our computer so you don't need to manually run this script in R yourself. The script will be scheduled to run hourly, as we're grabbing text on Bitcoin events from the last hour or so. You can access the full script, just see the link below the video. Now you can set this up as a task in task schedule in Windows, or you can do this through RStudio itself. I'll show you how to use the task schedule R package to easily schedule your web scraping script in RStudio. Otherwise you can check out our KD Nuggets tutorial link below on how to set this up using the task schedule interface. Now if you're using OS X, Automator would be the equivalent tool for this, and for Linux it would be Genome Schedule. And to do this in RStudio, the equivalent package to task schedule R for Mac users and for Linux is called cronR. The installation of cronR is fairly simple, and a link is provided below on how to do this. The functions in cronR are similar to those in task schedule R too. Let's go ahead and install and load task schedule R into R. So just uncomment and run this line to install. And don't forget to also run this line to load it into R. Now you can use the add-in interface. If you prefer to use the add-in interface, just install these packages here. And then once installed, go to the add-ins drop-down menu at the top here. Select Schedule R Scripts on Windows. And you can upload your script here. And you can schedule it hourly, daily, weekly, or whatever time frame you're interested in. And just hit Create Task. Now, you might want to have your output data and logs go into another directory folder on your computer. Otherwise, by default, it goes into the task schedule R extension data folder inside your R folder. And also, this interface is very similar in cron R too. Okay, cool. So let's just use some basic task schedule R functions to schedule your web scraping script to have it run every hour. So we'll use the task scheduler create function. And now we're going to give it all our inputs into the function. So we'll start with giving our task a name. And I think I'll just call it our web scraping. Bitcoin, and sorry for the typo. Okay, cool. And we'll give it the full path to where our script sits. So in my case, it's just sit here in my web auto scripts folder. And if you're in Windows, don't forget to use double backslash. Okay, cool. And we want to schedule our script to run every hour. And we'll input the start time. Now you can specify a start time, but I'm just happy to go with the default time, which is my current time or my system time, and have it like kick off within 62 seconds. And I'll just follow that hour minute format. And you can also specify a date, but once again, I'm happy just to go with the default, which is my current date. Now, you just need to make sure that this matches your computer system's date format. So in my case, it's month followed by day. Okay, and we're also going to give it the R executable file to run our R script, and this usually sits within the bin folder in R. Okay, cool. Let's run this. Okay, the output states this was successful, so we have now set up our web scraping script to run every hour. It's also just a good idea, I'll show you what I mean, to check out your logs here. So the reason why you want to check your logs is to see if there were any errors running during the script causing it to halt or anything like that. So any data saved as the output and the logs are stored in the same directory path of where your script lies. And we gave this to task schedule function up here, this path here. And basically, I've put little print statements in my web scraping script to help with debugging and such. And my actual output is an email alert, so I'll either receive an updated email summarizing Bitcoin events within the last hour or not. Just a couple of other things that I wanted to show you is just basically, like, you might decide to stop running your script later or delete it altogether. And in this case, you simply want to use the task scheduler stop function and just feed it the task name. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'll just copy and paste the name of your stop here. Okay, great. We've successfully kind of stopped our task, and to delete it, we'll just use the task scheduler delete function. Okay, cool. And that's it. After, you know, successfully creating a task, you can close out of RStudio and this will run in the background of your computer. Something to take note of, you do need to keep your computer on in order to have the script run in the background, so you just can't let it go to sleep. Power consumption is something you might want to think about. You can change your power and sleep settings in Windows, and if you're, you know, using a Mac, it would be your power and it'll be your energy saving settings. Thanks for watching. If you found the video tutorial useful, give us a like. Otherwise, you can check out our other video tutorials at Data Science Dojo Tutorials.